Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Let's Play Northgard. My name is Weasel, and Northgard is a strategy RTS which borrows elements from The Settlers, from even Civ, from Banished, and it's a really fun game. I had a lot of fun playing a short little round with my Twitch chat who's with me. We're going to start a fresh new game. I got to point out the resolution of this game, you can change the interface resolution. So, since I'm playing in 1440p, this is probably the resolution you also want to watch to get, you know, the text to read it. Anyways, I will explain it as good as best as I can. I don't know too much about the game. I have the basics down, I have a rough idea. We're going to start a fresh new game. This is not a campaign-based game yet. You only have single-player mode. There will be multiplayer and a campaign. We're going to be a blue... We're going to be... blue, that's our color, and the player named Weasel. We're gonna play normal, and we have three AI players. You get to select from several clans. Fenrir clan is giving you a little bit of a weapon smith mileage, a little bit more of attack in the beginning, and they eat this food, provide happiness, and I cannot pronounce this, the elk clan, let's call it that, will give you more food and wood at the start, and also you get more fame in certain situations. And you start with free sheep and you use less food as the Hydron clan. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do work with the Hydron clan. I want some sheep in the beginning. This sounds very friendly. There are different victory conditions similar to games like Civ, where there's not only one condition, but yes, several that you can use to win a round. If we go under victory conditions here, you can win by domination, fame, trait, or wisdom, which is fairly interesting. Wisdom has a upgrade tree similar, like a very short version similar to games like Civ, where you upgrade that, or other games. Just Civ is the one that, you know, comes to mind the most. We start with our little town hall here and a few villagers, and we get to build houses. We only get to build a certain amount per houses per square, but we can get more by exploring the areas around you. Right now, we don't know anything. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build my first scout camp in here, right in the middle. How many can we build? 5 houses in the first area. That's pretty good, I want to say. So I'm also going to build a house, so if our... Actually, I can wait a little bit. We have 3 out of 5 population. The town hall will slowly generate more villagers, so you want to make sure you have enough room for that. The woodcutter's lodge. Train your villagers to become a woodcutter so you can harvest wood in this area. Wood is, like, probably one of the most important resources you can have. So I kind of want to move it into the next area. I want to wait until we have a scout. You assign them by putting this guy in your scout camp. And yeah, I really hope that in future versions they will enable UI scaling. All right, go ahead and start looking here. He will reveal that area, and then he's going to work on his own in other ones. I want to have this area, and I want to colonize it as fast as possible so I can build a woodcutter lodge in there, whatever it's called. Woodcutter camp? Yeah. All right, there we go. He's doing its thing. The chat has been helping me quite a bit figuring this game out. There's a few people here that know quite a bit more, and that has been really helpful. So if I miss something, if I do something wrong, it's because I am not as familiar with the game yet. One thing that I would also love to see is turning around the view, but you can't as a static just from one side, so you can't turn even in 90 degree angles, which is a bummer. Would love to see that. But yeah, it's reminiscent also of Age of Empires. Okay, so now that we have this area, we can colonize it for 20 food. The more you colonize, the more food it's gonna cost. And this one is great for my woodcutter camp because it improves wood production by 20%, which you probably can't read if you have it at a low resolution. Okay, so we're gonna build our woodcutter lodge in here. And we can build up to 2 houses in this area. Oh, there's a stone, what do you call it? There's just stones. So we can build a mine here to extract stones, which is also fantastic, which is a thing we're going to need in the future. He keeps exploring. Excellent. I will build a house because that is also what I'm going to need to get more villagers. So let's go ahead and build one here. They usually automatically run there to do this. And here we got ruins. Treasure is waiting, but only scouts will have the courage to venture here. Hey, scout, venture here. Will you, please? I mean, it's treasure. It says only scouts are... Oh, I probably have to colonize this area, but there's 2 wolves in here, so I need warriors first to deal with them. That's fine. Okay. Hey, how about you, my friend, go ahead and build that woodcutter's lodge? Okay, so far so good. We are a little low on... excuse me, low on wood. Up here we get an idea if we're increasing or decreasing certain resources. And there's lore, which is also a resource which you can increase by having lore masters on certain objects. But on that, it just slowly ticks up and you will be able to upgrade certain things. Alright, have a good nap, Kate. So far, so good. That lodge is... sorry, that lodge is done. And we're going to assign two woodcutters to it. You need to assign them manually to it. And they are going to become, well, woodcutters. So you get an idea in the lower right corner where the chat is a little bit overlapping. This is where we have our woodcutters, villagers, scouts, and everyone else listed. Also our warriors. Once we will have them. Let's see, woodcutters lodge. For a training camp, we need 80 wood. So we're just going to have to wait until they get their shit done. I could work on a mine first. It's going to cost me 50 wood. Nah, you know what? I'm going to build a warrior camp, a training camp first. And then I'm going to build the mine. I do want to upgrade the town hall. And for that, we're going to need crowns. Crowns are... what are crowns? Excellent question. Excellent question. Crowns are just another resource which you get by building something like a trading post, which I don't have yet. Okay. I'm going to build the training camp in here next to the town hall. This is a runestone. Fantastic. You can recruit lore masters, which will produce lore. So I will colonize this. This area is nice as well. Can build three buildings in here. And what do I see? Yeah. One lore can be harvested here. So I will get that. And I'm going to assign a villager directly to that runestone. Oh, shit. We have wolves attacking. I'm going to send all my people there, including my sheep, apparently. Yes. Sheep, let the sheep attack. Just punch the wolf. All right. So now that that is done, I'm going to have to send them back. Go, woodcutter. And go. You have to basically tell them to go back, otherwise they won't. Rather silly, but so be it. So this area is... Yes, we have a lore master, so our lore goes up by plus 5 instead of plus 2. So that's good. We're currently working on the training camp. Can't harvest a wolf. Wolf meat is apparently not tasty enough. And we need more wood, so they're working on this. Yeah, okay. I think, yeah, I'm gonna build the mine next. 50 is required for this. We can build one mine and one forest in here, which is fine. Is one villager assigned? No, not yet. So I'm gonna send him to work on this. We have 7 out of 10, so I would probably want to build another house fairly soon. Wait, you're not my scout. You are the enemy scout. Look at that, they're fairly close. And those are giants. I have not seen them before. Aren't those lovely? Aren't those just the loveliest? Big-ass giants. Cool, the enemy's already over here. I want to get this area before he gets it. But that is going to require some warriors. So let's go ahead and... I'm going to get two warriors, even though that's fairly early on for this. I think we have enough food to survive the winter when it comes. All right, let's attack. Ah, shit. No, don't give me wolf. I just want to work, attack one wolf. All right, fall back. Gonna take it a little bit easier here. Oi, oi, that's the only thing that the warriors say. Oi, oi, oi. Okay, one warrior can take on a wolf, so I'm not too worried. Excellent. What I also want to build is a sheep den, or whatever you want to call this. A sheep fold requires 80 wood, which I still don't have. So be it. But now that we have these two guys, where's my scout master? Scout, scout, scout. Scout, there you are. How about you venture here? Oh, you still can't venture there. Why? Oh, because I probably need to colonize this area. This is looking good. There's a draugr. Scouts don't get attacked. They can't get attacked. So that's, I guess, a good thing. Oh, shit. He's already attacking me. Come on, dude. Take it down a notch, will you? I don't have a healer. He's luckily stuck in a tree. Shit. Come on. No. Fuck. They're going to try to colonize us, aren't they? God damn it. I don't want that. Okay. I need another warrior. All right, guys. Attack! The weak one, stay back a little bit. That's, what, of course, what he's going to try to go for first. All right, warrior dead. Excellent. Can't colonize, not enough food. We're actually going down on food. I have to build something to offset the cost of my warriors. So how about we take this weak warrior and we're going to assign him to another post, like the scout camp. No, how about we don't do that? I need something useful to assign him to. What if I just make him into a villager? There you go. I need a healer's hut for this, so I'm going to build a healer's hut right in the town center over here. We have 10 out of 10, so I also need another house to get more villagers, even though I don't have enough food as of right now. Where would be a good area to build this? Can't grow it, needs more houses. And it is winter. Not a good time for attacking anything. And we're low on food, so we might have a hard time to survive the winter. Where's my sheepfold? Didn't I start building a sheepfold at one point? Healer's hut. Nope, I did not. So what we need to do is we need to slaughter a sheep. Not too happy about this. Slaughter, 80 food. Yep, sorry. Cool. That should bring us hopefully through the winter. You don't want to necessarily slaughter them because you can build a sheepfold, which allows you to harvest food from them. Okay, this is probably the area that I want. Colonize for 80. I'm not colonizing anything right now. Not enough food. Trading post requires 80 wood. Yeah, keep doing your thing. It's quite all right. I also need to assign someone to be a miner to start mining. One will do so far, I think. Nobody's building this hut right now. Come on, dude. Build the hut. When you have a warrior in your village, you lose happiness. Oh! Well, then let's send them somewhere else. Oh, yeah. We have too many wounded. Actually, yeah, no. You get villagers. When you make a warrior into a villager, you lose happiness. Gotcha. Villagers make people happy. That's good. Expected happiness, 1. Current happiness, we have too many wounded. Yeah, I'm working on this. We need a healer. So I'm going to assign this villager, who's, you know, nearly dead, to become a healer. He's now going to gather herbs and it's going to heal anyone who's within borders. I really have to work hard on getting more food. Food is probably the most important thing that I can do right now. Okay, there's my sheepfold. I will have to build this here. Not necessarily too happy about that, whatever. But once we have the sheepfold, we can assign 2 sheep to it and they will generate a steady income of food, which is not high enough. Damn it. Okay. They're starving. Fantastic. We need more food. We need to store more food. I need to probably kill a sheep, won't I? Clan is starving. Fine. I will need to slaughter sheep. Bummer. Was not properly prepared for the winter. Okay, not that fine again. Should have built a sheepfold earlier on. Okay, those are slowly getting healed up. Come on, build that sheepfold. Will you, please? It's going to take it a bit. Okay, nearly done. All right, now we put one sheep in there. I sadly don't have more, but you can get more by colonizing areas. This looks like a great area to build a, what is it called? Hunter? Fisherman's hut? Hunter's lodge? Yeah. Requires deer, yeah. So we need to colonize this first. Requires 80. Sorry. Sorry about that. I have something stuck in my throat. It's the worst. Slaughter villagers for cheap! Yeah, that's a good idea. Okay, at least our food is not going down too much. Our villagers are now collecting food. This is generating a little bit of food. So I'm fairly happy about this. Let's see, hunter. I really want to get this area. Because they're going to get probably a foothold over me there. But they probably also have to consider their resources. I'm going to keep one building slot free so I could technically build a tower in here. I would love to build it in here first. But yeah, we'll have to colonize this. Oh, there's a warrior in there. He's blocking this right now from getting colonized. Well, how about Brosef? Get the warriors in here, will ya? Oh, it has sour relations. Well, that's a bummer. Yeah, go and attack him. Let's see how this is going for you. Oh, it's going bad for you. You're dying. Oh, what a bummer. Yeah, that's what I like to see. Okay, this one needs to move back into the borders. And I want to build a trading post soon too, but I need to find more sources of food. Requires fish. I don't have fish. Requires colonize for 80 food. Can't colonize this. Need to make more food. That's a bummer. That's a big bummer. I need to colonize more. And I don't want to slaughter the sheep to get that. Okay, do I get any sheep from here? No, no sheep. This only has stone. That's great. This is really bugging me, though. This is indeed really bugging me. We're getting more villagers that are going to harvest. Why are you not harvesting any food? You are literally the worst. Literally the worst villager that I could have. Okay, trading post will create crones, which I'm going to need to upgrade my house. But first, where is fish? We're going to wait a second, then I'm going to colonize this and build a hunter's hut. Hunter's lodge is 60 wood. I have plenty of wood. Wood is not the concern of us. Our scout was hurt while exploring a new area. Oh no, poor scout. It's a bummer. I think I will colonize this. Even though this is the better region, I can protect it with my warrior inside here for now. But as soon as I have 80 food, this will be colonized. Bam, colonize. Okay, now the next thing is going to be the hunter's lodge. Come on. Da, 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 da. Waiting until this works up. Alright, this goes here. So how is that warrior going? It's not healed yet. I would love to attack the enemy right now, but I don't see this happening while they're not healed. Okay, Hunter's Lodge. I need a villager to build this, please. Get going on this. We need hunters. I will probably assign two of them if I can. Okay, there's my scout who's doing its thing. I'm a little bit worried about those Draugrs here because they might decide to attack any friggin' time. Need more food. Okay. What I can also do is I can build now a, where is it? Trading post. And I'll probably will do this in here. Okay, this is nearly done. Because we need crones. I love that they're written with an umlaut. The U. Exciting. I think we have enough stone. 11. It'll do for now. Okay, you're immediately going to become a hunter. You're immediately going to become a hunter. Go and hunt. Excellent. Excellent. I have no idea how much that provides. If I had another sheep, that would also be great. So I can only build one hut, one building on this, even though it costs 80. So I can't really defend it with a tower. Quite the bummer. I will be able to defend this area if I build a tower here, though. This is going to cost me 120 food. You can keep up the building upkeep. One of your quarry has been damaged. Repair it, it will burn. Oh, what? Shit. Okay. Oh, I don't produce enough crones, so I can't have the upkeep going. Okay. That's fine. The quarry needs to be repaired. We can't acquire new knowledge. Oh, I forgot to upgrade my lore all the time. Okay. More crone production. Okay. Now we have the upkeep again. Merchant will produce more crones. Actually, two more lore and two more of this. We're going to work on trading. That's excellent. And repair. Okay, good enough. That was a close call. Build a trade route. Nah, not yet. I need also another hut, another house, for which I require more crones. Guess I'm going to assign the villagers to become training masters. I forgot. Merchants. That's the word that I'm looking for. Okay, you keep harvesting food, which is only at +3. 120. Needs more food. Weasel needs more food. Okay, at least the clones upkeep is running well. I need to build a house. Can I even build another house? No, I cannot. I'm actually limited right now, so I need to colonize a new area. Ideally, the ruins. Yeah, it needs more houses. Fully aware of that. Okay, how about I bring that warrior back? I bring that warrior back. Let them heal up. And then I might attack. I don't see a warrior right now. I don't see a warrior as of right now, so maybe we can do some damage. You know what? Let's do this. Let's just attack and see what they got. They got nothing, so be it. Let's do that. Yeah, kill that villager. Make his life miserable. No, 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 no. Don't fight like this, you idiots. useless. You're useless. Great, they won't attack. Oh, there's two warriors. Okay, never mind. They have two warriors. I do not want. Do not want. 120 food. If I take this, this is going to reduce my food production. But I need it. This has two stone. Three buildings can be built. I need to build here. Build a trade route. Yeah, I can't. All right, then. More food production. What do I have here? Just iron. There's more deer. This is a tricky situation. And what time is it? It is October, so winter is actually going to come fast. They have invested our food. We lost 34 food. We should build more food silos. God damn you. This is the worst. Absolute worst. Oh, Scar. Oh, they have a farm? Oh, I need a farm. That's a good idea. If only I had the food for that. I guess I can upgrade my town hall. I have way too much food going. Wood. So I'm just going to help this guy to harvest the 11 stone that are left. Then I can maybe build another building. Ah, yeah, good times. So this guy needs to move over so our healer does its job of properly healing. Because right now he's not healing anyone. You're not healing anyone right now. So once this is gone, I can remove the quarry. Scout camp doesn't need to be upgraded. Sheepfold! They produce 100% more food. Yeah, I could assign more food if I had more sheep. Which I don't, because I had to slaughter them because of insufficient planning. I do need another house because villagers can... they can gather food. So if... slaughter. Colonize for 120. I'm colonizing this. I need room to build another house. And hopefully there's something useful in the treasure. All right, okay, let's start building the house. And give me treasure. Our scout died. No, scout died. That's no good. Okay, make a new one. All right, Brosef. You're going to go and explore this ruin now. I hope there's something good in there. Exciting. This building is full. There's five more stones. Good. It's a start. It's a start. Brewery, food silo, marketplace, carved stone... Where is a farm? Fields requires fertile land, which I don't have. And it is winter. We are boned. Minus 9 food. We're going to starve. This is going to happen. This is going to be my... This is going to happen. Let's face it. This is going to happen. So I'm going to make use of me attacking them. Yeah, go and kill that woodcutter there. Yeah, maybe the warriors are busy right now. Yep, warriors are busy right now. We're just inflicting some damage. Come on, leave! Well, and I lost my warriors. That wasn't smart at all. They got stuck. Got to be surrounded. Well. No food, just make more people. It's fine. Minus 5. Well, currently my hunters are... we reduced that a little bit, so they're not starving as fast. This can be destroyed, yes, because they got rid of that stone. Let's just hope we're going to be fine and they're not going to attack us in the near future. And we will survive the winter. Because we are going to, we're currently in the process of starving slowly. We still have the hunters. Area's full of deer. Yeah, that would be great to have. Let's just find food in there in the ruins, please. Let's find food in there. I just realized I... Why don't you remind me that I can do these things? Sharp axes reduce food consumption of 5. Cool. Our scouts found ancient riches. We have gained 100 kroons and 50 lore. Exciting. Exciting. All of that. All of that. Well, then. Brewery, become brewers who will now increase your happiness. Marketplace, more currents. Yes, yes, yes. So be it. Where can I find fertile lands, though? Nowhere. There's just meat. I think this? No. This must be the only guys that have farms. Can't grow because it's unhappy. Well, that's... We're starving. We're sick. And we have too many wounded. Do we not have a healer? Somebody has reached. Come on, guys, survive. Don't die on me. Right now, we're not getting the next villager. I need my happiness to grow. Okay. I guess I could heal someone by adding another villager to this. Minus 8 food. Ugh. I take it back. Become a villager rather than an herbalist. Maybe you can gather a little bit of food in the winter. Maybe. We'll see. We'll see. It's soon over. We're going to be having summer soon. Yay! And we have... How many buildings can we build? 3 buildings. So we'll build at least one building that will allow us to make some food, hopefully. It won't. I'm going to build a defense tower because you can all suck a big fat one. Burn, burn, burn.